in a time of multi-layered CGI. And media propaganda. In a time when people begin to look beyond the lies and control, and awaken to the truth. One truth remains, just waiting to be found. Truth known since the dawn of creation. And God said, "Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters, and let there be lights in the firmament to divide the night from the day." And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. Part 1. Divine Creation.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light.
The first time I saw sonoluminescence was in a darkened room. I was transfixed to look at this flask of fluid.
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the water,
A tiny spot of bright light contained in a flask of liquid.
And you look into the center, and in the center, see a glowing blue-purple light, which could be seen with the unaided eye.
This star in a jar is made when a sound wave is passed through a small bubble inside a flask of liquid. And this sound wave, and this sound wave, sound wave.
And God said, and God said, and God said.
And this collapse happens so violently that vapor molecules trapped inside the bubble slam together and heat up so much that the bubble gives off an incredible burst of heat and light, several thousand times a second, giving the appearance of a star.
Part 2. Controlled opposition.
You stand up, bring me down. a fairy pass right through. And I see what I see, the world is over me. So I reach up to the sky and pretend that I'm a spaceman. I'm not a place and time, I guess I'm looking for a brand new peace. Is there a better life for me? Let me
try these on. Look, you crazy mother. Put these on.
Hey! Stay away from me!
I'm telling you, you dumb son of a...
The Matrix is a system, Neo. That system is our enemy. But when you're inside, you look around, what do you see? Businessmen, teachers, lawyers, carpenters. The very minds of the people we are trying to save. But until we do, these people are still a part of that system, and that makes them our enemy. You have to understand, most of these people are not ready to be unplugged. And many of them are so inert, so hopelessly dependent on the system, that they will fight to protect it.
Locked!
Part 3. Questions and answers. The year is 2015. This is 1997. See anything different?
There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. If you fool me, we can't get fooled again.
And what you're seeing here is a mirage. We typically would not be able to see this from the Lake Michigan shore. We talked about this last night. Conditions are right on the lake that we're actually seeing a mirage of the Chicago skyline.
Explain how a sun 93 million miles away can produce a heat spot like this.
But they are the gatekeepers. They are guarding all the doors, they are holding all the keys, which means that sooner or later, someone is going to have to fight them.
Horizon lines and the point of convergence. Notice how the water is a big ramp that ramps up to your eye level. Unless ships can fly. What about sunsets? Light reacts very differently when put inside water. Even the globe model has to account for light refraction. What about Felix's free fall from the edge of space? fisheye lenses cause an image to bend and warp, creating an illusion. If this is a true reflection of the Earth, then where have the vast amounts of oceans gone? Here is a true perspective of the Earth, taken from the exact same height. Where is the curvature? Solar and lunar eclipses. The moon and the sun both follow their own unique paths throughout the year. The reason why the sun and moon appear to be the same size is because they are. This 1800s map reveals something rather fascinating. A magnetic force of pole star directly above the center of the Earth. Could this blocking of the sun be the reason why we are able to witness a lunar eclipse, even when both the moon and sun are seen clearly visible in the sky above us? The moon phases. It's simply about perspective. Clouds behind the sun. Truth hidden in plain sight. What about places such as Alaska, which receives periods of 24 hours sunlight, followed by months of total darkness? As previously shown, the sun acts as a spotlight, rotating around the flat Earth. Notice how much more darkened the sky has become already, even with the sun still clearly visible in the sky above. During the summer solstice, the sun would appear to never fully set, as it would always be rotating close to the center of the Earth. What about people who have circumnavigated the world? This is probably the most common question I hear. Yet, the easiest to understand. First, we need to establish the equator line. And you will notice, all points remain exactly the same. The only difference is the South Pole. So, Let's bear east and see what happens. Congratulations, you have just circumnavigated the Earth. The only way to prove the Earth was round would be to travel independently via north and south. And you only need to ask those who have attempted before to find out what happens when you do. Jarl Antoy was arrested in Chile after sailing into Antarctic waters for the second time in 2 years. So, is there any actual evidence of the dome itself? Job 26:10, He hath compassed the waters with bounds.
One of the strangest places on the ocean's floor was only just discovered in the 1990s. Degree is one of a handful of people to ever see it in person.
Without a doubt, one of the most amazing things that I have ever seen in the bottom of the ocean. It was while filming for Blue Planet. It was in the Gulf of Mexico. I noticed there's something out in the distance. Couldn't tell exactly what, but it looked like a dark band. And as we approached it, the dark band became a donut. I saw this donut. It was black in the center. What the heck is that? And so, as we get closer and closer to it, I noticed that the black band had what appeared to be kind of steam over it. And then I looked, and there was water lapping against the shoreline. This band was a ring of mussels. And inside the ring of mussels was a lake. And it's like, wait a minute, I'm already underwater. And we went out over the water in this lake and tried to descend it and bounced off. It was so super saline and dense that the submarine couldn't go down it. We literally bounced off.
Fly those?
Absolutely.
Do you get to fly to the edge?
Oh, yeah.
What's past there?
Don't know. We're not allowed to fly past that.
Let's go.
It's against the rules, Jonas.
Who are you?
The Giver. When the elders need guidance, I provide wisdom using memories of the past. Our world was different. There was more.
More?
Much more. There is no way for me to prepare you for the truth.
Thank you.
Part 4, The Bible. Isaiah 40, 22, it is he who sits above the circle of the earth. Job 38, 14, it is like clay under the seal, and its features stand out like a garment. Proverbs 8, 27, when he established the heavens, I was there, when he drew a circle on the face of the deep. Job 26, 10. He has inscribed a circle on the face of the waters, at the boundary between light and darkness. Revelations 20, 1. Then I saw an angel coming down from heaven, holding in his hand the key to the bottomless pit. Revelation 7:1, after this I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth. Job 37:18, as thou, like him, spread out the sky, which is strong as a molten looking glass. Genesis 11:4, then they said, come, let us build ourselves a tower with its tops in the heavens, and let us make a name for ourselves. Matthew 4:8. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain, and showed him all the kingdoms of the world. Isaiah 66:1. Heaven is my throne, and the earth my footstool. Save the Lord. 1 Samuel 2:8. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and on them he has set the world. Daniel 4:11, the tree grew and became strong, and its top reached to heaven, and it was visible to the ends of the whole earth. Matthew 24:29, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will fall from heaven. Revelation 1:7, behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him.
And I see what I see, and the world is over me. So I reach up to the sky and pretend that I'm a spaceman. I'm not. Double.